Hello everyone and welcome. This is the first video I'm recording in Blender, and this is a tutorial on how to create these instruments. So this is musical instrument, and I will try to create it from scratch. And first we are going to model it, and secondly we are going to texture this wooden texture and make this simple strands. This is the dimensions of the instrument, and this is the drum we are going also to create. So we have three or two instruments we are going to create from scratch. So let's begin and start with new scene. This is the timeline we are going not to make, and this is the filter cube. Let's delete and dimension. So we have choices to add our background image. If we open the reference, we can add any of these instruments as background. If we say this is the front and single image and dimensions, we can change the opacity, let's say 0.3, and this is the size of the image. I make it the default of 10, and this is the rotation. Also, if you have a flipped image, you can rotate it to become straight, and but in our case we have to change it slightly like that. But as I have mentioned, I am not going to use this image, but to show you the way to enable your background image, but I am not using this in my model. So if we have, take a look in our set. First, I'm going to model this instrument, and secondly, we are going to model a drum. So we have this bass and this two parts here. It's this model is symmetrical, and we have also here logo. We are not going to make it, but I will show you the way to texture it in Photoshop. And this we have the third part which is here, and we have a hidden parts here. Like wires or something like that. We will try to make it also, and finally the fourth part, which is the strands or these pipes. So we are here in Blender, and we will add plane. This plane, let's say that is the top. If we have going to edit mode and enable lens, our lens. We also metric, so this is 2 meter by 2 meter. So if we go to dimensions, let's say the x will be 0.3, as we have 30 centimeter, and y, let's say, will be 0.1. So we have, if we go to edit mode, we have 2 meter. So we will apply the rotation and the scale, and gone again. So we have the right scales, 10 centimeter and 30 centimeter. This is the right dimensions of our model. So this is the top view, and we gone to front view and rotate this in x by 90 degrees, and gone on z by 0.05 centimeter. So it will be rest on our grid. So this is the first part. Let's make or add dimensions thickness to this. So we will extrude on y slightly, like, let's say 1 centimeter, by shift like that. And also apply rotation and scale, let's try to add our screencasting. It's not enabled in this version. So we have here the first part, which is the left part. Let's duplicate it, shift D Y or G Y 0.09. So this is this space is 10 centimeters. We have also here another part. So we have shows this part and this part. This part is slightly taller than this part. So we have choices. We can make it from scratch, or we can go again and choose one of these parts and duplicate in Y, rotate it 90 degrees, and scale on Y, let's say 0.333. We will make it thickness smaller as X, like that. I hope I have my screencasting enabled, but I will try to download it from the website. And anyway, so we have the choices to go to this and enable edges, lens, and also enable this vertex mode. It's a simple process, but I try to make you familiar with the interface of Blender. So GY and go to this edge, and also I try to make you familiar, become familiar with all the tools in this new software. So GY like that, and all go to GY like GX, move in X like that. So we have this the same tool, the same thickness. Let's make it smaller. Go to GX like that. Cool, man. So we have it the same tool, but another part. This is similar or simple process like that. You have the choice to duplicate in X and go to like that and GX and stick on that. So we have the main parts of our instrument. We will change the tool and change something different to make it exactly like this part. But until that, we will make this parts. If you have, we have zoomed here, we have bevel on this or smooth shading. We will make it now. Or let's make this part first. It's simple cube. So if we go to edit mode and select this top face, we must have our cube on this face. So shift S, cursor is selected to make our cursor centered onto this face. And in the object mode, we will add plane. Our plane is very, very large. Our plane is very, very large. So we have changed dimensions. Dimensions here 2 meter in X, but we have it like, let's say, 2 centimeters. And Y, let's say, 0.1. So we have the right dimensions, or we must have the right dimensions. 2 centimeters, 2 centimeters. Yeah, it's 2 centimeters. Or let's say 0.025, 0.022. Alright, so 2 centimeters and 0.2 is the right dimensions. And we must have thickness to it. So in edit mode, EZ. Like that, so we have thickness to it. So our cube or this tool is extended outer the main edge. So in edit mode, vertex extrude or scale y again with shift slightly outer the main edge. So we have the main part, but we should in the edit mode take this and move it. You can use mirror modifier to simplify this process, but it's now the time to add these edges, these smoother edges. It's simply process. Let's add some edges here, edge here, unenable this, and another edge here, and another edge here, and another edge here, and apply smooth modifier. So modifier subdivision surface, let's say two or three. So I will take this edge and slide like that, or take this edge and slide so it became more available to the eye, and add the smooth shading. Be sure that you add smooth shading in object mode, not on edit mode. So we have our first part. It's very, very fantastic. So in this second part, it's very similar to this, but simply has this edge. So I will take the same cube and duplicate on X, rotate 90 degree, and for moment I will disable this subdivision surface. Take this cube and let's our origin is here. You can make it by Control Shift C on geometry, will be the center in here. Take this. If you see here, we have our cube simply smaller in Y dimensions. Gone to solid mode and take this and simply make it like that. So how we can get this sharp edge? So if you look, we have edge here and edge here. So we will make or take these vertices and up. First, we will take this edge and slide here, slide, and make this vertices taller, and for moment make it in the same edge. So we can re-enable our subdivision surface, and it's very fantastic. So we have to make simple change. The change is it must be smaller in Y. So in the Y dimensions, SY, let's 0.992. And it must have if you look at the images, you have this edge is slightly sharp, not like here. If you look, it's very circular. So how we can get it? We can add bevel for this edge. We can for this edge, you can make it the crease and it do the job. But the process, which is the familiar or popular process, is make edge here and slightly gone to the far away, like that. And take this edge and slightly make like that, and take this edge and slightly make like that. So you have two results. You have clean, sharp edges, and you have also circular edges. But this I will try to make it gone here, or make this and re-enable and GX like that. Cool man. So I will mirror this on the other in the other edge, boys, make it, let's say, make it mirror and add mirror modifier. The mirror object is mirror in the X, and the another time add mirror modifier. Mirror modifier on the mirror object is MIR, and on the X nothing fancy. If you have seen these photos, we have this part. The right part is simply wide, not wider, but narrower than the other. So let's make it happen. We will take this in the edit mode and vertex and take these parts and enable lens for a moment. So we will take it like that. So if we have used dimensions, let's say GY, let's say 0.02, right? And the other one, the same process, make this vertices GY minus 0.02. But it seems away. So let's make it happen another time. So we will use stick with these dimensions, 2 centimeter inside and 2 centimeter inside in the other side. So we have completed the two parts. Let's try to make this upper part. It's simply array of this object. I will make one object and take array and let's make it inside Blender. So it's simply plane. We will go here in any of these faces and select our face and cursor to selected. Alright, so we add plane. This plane is fairly big. We can change dimensions in the same time. In the X, let's say it will be 1 centimeter on the X, and the Y, let's say it will be 0.13. We will stick or start by 0.13. Let's hide the properties. If we go here, it's simply the right dimensions we have to start. But I see that 1 centimeter is simply small. So SX, let's scale on X like that. Scale on X like that. So this is the first object we will start. So this object has some thickness, and the thickness is simply has this curve. So we will make it happen. Select in the edit mode, select all and extrude on Z like that. Add, let's say five edges here and scale on Z. Scale on Z and B shift uncheck this uncheck and scale on Z again. Scale on Z uncheck this only select the mid and scale on Z like that. Like that. Cool man. So we have this cube the first. If we have go to mirror modifier and subdivision surface, we must use subdivision surface. But first we will make edge here and another edge here on this side. So we must add smooth modifier. So this is the first part. It seems the same, but it's on Z must be squished. All right, like that. Nothing fancy, and it seems we have to take these edges and these edges and scale on Z. Take these edges and these edges and scale on Z like that, and make some edge loops here. So this is the right drum, not drum, but some slightly edge loops. So we will take this and slide again here, slide this control E edge slide and control E edge slide. What I'm going to make it very circular, not sharp. The edge must be circular, not sharp. And on the other side, it must be circular, not sharp again. It must be circular. So this is the first one. I will make array modifier here, array modifier. And we must have, let's say, we in the photo, if we count it. So in the photo, we have 13 part. I will make 13 on the X and the spacing. Let's make the spacing like that, 1.5, let's say 1.5, not 1.5, but 1.65. Or 1.62, good. And apply the array modifier. Take every one of these in the edit mode. Take every one, and you can make it another object by B separated by selection, and scale on X, scale on Y. 0.98, and here this is very simple process. B separated by selection and make it B separated by selection and change again B separated by selection. So I will pause the video until I will separate all these and change the sizes and dimension to be similar to the image. So the way I have created it, I will separated, I have separated all these vertices after applying mirror modifier, and make simply scales on y. Let's say it will be 0.98 and it will be 0.95 and it will be like that, simply some changes. So up to this moment we have finished the main parts of this instrument. Let's make the final part with these strands. It's simply strands, but I will try to simulate it perfectly like this. And it will it will have some changes. So in our new layer, in the center, I will make cylinder. This cylinder is fairly big. I am not going to use these all vertices, but I want only it. Let's this the radius will be 0.02 or 0.005. This is the radius, and the depth will be, let's say, 0.15, and this is our cylinder. 5 millimeter is the radius, let's say 0.003. Alright, so SZ 1.5. So we have the main cylinder. After that, we must add some loop cuts here. Bevel this loop cut slightly, bevel, and S. Shift Z, scale on X or Y, or extrude first, and S shift Z, like that, slightly with shift, and it will be like that. We have the chance to make the another part. So we will add some loop cuts here, another loop cut. It will be textures. This part will be textures. And again, loop cut fairly on the top. Add smooth modifier. And here is the trick, control 2, to add loop cuts with the subdivision of 2. Let's have a look. Alright. So I will make some changes after the smooth modifier. We will make some loop cuts here and loop cuts here and loop cuts here. Alright. If you have look, these parts must be gone slightly on the bottom. So we have the main part here, and it's the time to make the spherical ball. So we will have this mouse here and add simply UV sphere. It's very big again, and we will scale it 0.1, scale again 0.2, and in this size we will move it here and move it here. It's also big, so let's scale again and add smooth modifier and with this smooth shading and move it here. So we have the main part here, this main part. We can group them control J, or we have to add an empty like So the trick here or to parent these all these items to this MBT, we will make it select this strands and select the MBT object and the control B object and select this and select the MBT and the control B T object. And if we make any changes, it will be in the same. And let's say shift S selection to cursor. Again, it's this seems to be slightly like that. So this is the first, and we have the chance to move it shift DX and move it on first layer. This here, it seems very fantastic. And let's RX 90 degrees on the X. We'll move it here and move again. In the photo like that, it's slightly, the sphere is slightly smaller. So we will make it happen, the sphere is slightly smaller, like that. To be honest, the sphere must be in this dimension. As I've mentioned, it's very, very simple. It's a very, very simple tutorial. So if you find everything hard, you can make comment in this video. So we have the first part here, the first part. This is the first and I must rotate these items like that and rotate again like that, rotate like that and move in the Z. So we have the first one and rotate on the Z, rotate and move here and shift DY. Shift all this, shift D Y and control M Y to mirror on Y, not mirror. So R Y or R Z like this. So we have all parts of this instrument. Let's hide this or these MBT objects. Let's move in another layer. So we have all objects in this instrument have been modeling. In this tutorial, I have to finish in this part. This is the first part in my tutorial about modeling this simple instrument. In this tutorial.